watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you. Can you believe it? It is January 2010. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the new year. I'm really so excited about the new year. And, you know, we're all excited. We all get excited about newness, right? About new things, be it a new car or a new job or a new relationship, a new pet, you know, a new dress, whatever it is. We get excited about newness, about new things. But particularly, I get more excited about a new year. And you know why? Because with each new year comes new opportunities. New opportunities. That's what each new year brings your way. New opportunities. Opportunities to reach your dreams. You know, opportunities to forge new relationships. You know, opportunities to make a difference, you know. It's like with each new year, God is literally giving us, you know, a new lease at life, a new shot. You know, we get another opportunity to get into the game of life and to succeed at it. So that's one big reason why I always get excited about the new year. The other reason is that each new year crowns you and I as survivors. Okay, so I'm going to say it this way. Happy New Year to a survivor. Don't look around the room now and think, who is she talking to? I'm talking to you. You're a survivor. You don't need to have participated in the TV reality series, you know, Survivor, and be a winner for you to be a survivor. But just think about this for a moment. With each new year, it crowns you a survivor. Imagine and just think about everything you went through in 2009. Think about all the challenges. Look at and just think for a moment at everything you overcame. And then look at it this way and say, you know what? I survived. I overcame. You know, so you're a survivor. You're an overcomer. You're more than a conqueror. You're still here in 2010 and you're still standing strong. So, wow, congratulations. Congratulations. And you know, that means that for 2010, there is absolutely nothing to fear. Nothing to fear whatsoever. I want you to say that to yourself and say, you know, like I'm Bola, I'll say to Bola, Bola, there is nothing to fear for 2010. Nothing to fear for 2010. Nothing to fear whatsoever. Because you know why? If you survive 2009, that means, hey, you have what it takes to survive 2010. Plus, God hasn't brought you this far, okay, to abandon you. You know, he's going to be with you and he's going to strengthen you. And, you know, whatever 2010 brings, hey, you know that you can overcome it yet again. So, you know, congratulations to you again. And Happy New Year once again to a survivor. I'm really, really excited. And because there's nothing to fear, I want you to square your shoulders, you know. Put on your winning attitude and get ready to win in 2010. And do not forget that I am available, okay, 24/7 to help you in your journey in 2010 to realize your dreams, you know, to succeed and to succeed at work and in life. And I have a variety of powerful programs in person, on air, and online to help you to attain your goals in this new year. So just shoot me an email, visit my website at www.royalproclamations.com. Again, it's www.royalproclamations.com to learn more about all my coaching, training, and speaking programs that will really help you to reach your dreams and attain success at work and in life. So, well, that's it. With that encouragement, at least, we can now dive straight into the broadcast for today. And today we're looking at another of my Money Power program, and it's on which teaches the spiritual dimension of financial success. And we're looking at another spiritual principle for financial success, or like I like to say, for success in general, because you see, this principle, if you apply it, it works for financial success, it works for personal success, it works for dream realization. And it's none other than the visualization principle. So that's what we're going to be looking at today, the visualization principle. And it's taken from my Money Power program, which teaches the spiritual dimension of success. Let me just put it that way. And, you know, like I always say, there's more to making money than meets the eye. I don't want you to lose focus on that thought. You know, there's more to making money than meets the eye. And financial success is not, or success is not just a function of hard work and sound financial planning. There's so many intangible things that really can go a long way in influencing financial success. And we have looked at so many over the last couple of months. And, you know, to recap and to review, please go to my website at www.royalproclamations.com. And then you follow the link to the TV station. And all these broadcasts are available on demand at that website. So, you know, we're looking at visualization principle, like I said, today, particularly because, you know, this principle really helps us to, you know, reach our dreams. And I know that January, this is the time where we're all setting goals, we're making resolutions and all of that. And we're going to look at how, number one, we're going to define this principle. Number two, we're going to look at how this principle operates. And then we're going to look at, you know, examples of, you know, those who have applied the principle to their success. And then number four, we're going to look at how to apply it in our own lives, you know. So that's going to kind of going to be the outline. So let me start then, I guess, first by defining visualization. What do I mean? What does it mean to visualize, you know, something, you know? And, you know, I turned to the dictionary and a few words came and I put them together and I've come up with this definition. To visualize basically means to conceptualize, to have a, get a mental picture, you know, get a mental picture of a desired destination or a desired goal or a desired event. It's just to get a mental picture. You know, another word for it is to envision, you know, is to see something, to see a desired goal or future event, to see it with your mind's eye and get a picture of it in your mind of where you are, you'd really like to be, or where you're really, where you're going, or where your destination is. Okay, so that's what visualization is really all about. Now, how does this principle operate? You know, it operates in four basic ways. Number one, it operates by increasing our desire. You see, when we are strengthening our desire for the objective, for the goal that we have set for ourselves. So you see, because when we get this picture, like I said, get this mental picture of this goal, of this objective, of our destination, it increases the desire we have for it. You know, it enhances it. It strengthens that desire for it. And we know what happens when, you know, we have a very strong desire for something. You know, people say where there is a will, there's a way. You know, so when there's a strong desire, the way the visualization principle works is that, you know, you get that picture and then it increases the desire. And so you find that you're releasing all the energy that is within you, all your energy to try and accomplish that goal. That's one way it operates. It operates by increasing desire, you know. And like I said, when desire is so strong, you will always find a way, you know. I tell people, you know, who give me excuses for, oh, why I'm not losing weight or why I am not, you know, achieving result, goal. You know, I say to them, it's because the desire isn't strong enough, you know. If the desire is strong enough, you will find a way. That's the way human beings, that's the way we are engineered, okay. So that's one way that the visualization principle works. The second way it works is that it enhances your focus, okay? Because now you have this mental picture of where you're going. And so, you know, you can focus more on it, and it helps you also eliminate distractions, you know? And the third way it operates is that it increases your endurance. It increases endurance and your persistence. Because you got that picture in your mind, you know where you're going, it's strong in your mind, you've seen the final end, so you're not going to stop. You're not going to stop till you get there, you know. And so that's one of the powerful things about visualization. So three powers of visualization so far that I've touched on. The fourth power of visualization is that it increases motivation. Okay, because like I said, from number three, is that about the endurance and the persistence, is that, you know, the picture you have in your mind now is what keeps fueling you. It keeps motivating you. It keeps encouraging you to keep on keeping on, because you're not going to stop at anything short of that picture that you've already created in your mind. You're not there yet, so you're going to keep on going until you attain it. And then the fifth power of visualization, I don't know whether I said there were four, but I guess there's five now. The fifth power of visualization is that when you get this picture in your mind's eye, when you can really kind of envision it, and when you can see where you're going, you know, you are able to tap into creative power. It releases creative power. It releases creativity. And so what that does is that, you know, it releases the energy and the power for you to able to attract that desired goal into your life. It really opens up your mind to be able to also receive, you know, this goal, this objective, you know, from God. So those are the five powers of visualization, or the five ways in which visualization works. I'm going to take them again. Number one, it really helps it enhances focus. You know, it enhances focus because you've got the picture ahead of you, and so you're focused on it. It will eliminate all distractions because, you know, you're not going to stop until you get to where you're going, you know. And if you come across anything else that's not that picture, you're going to say, no, this is a distraction. I know exactly where I'm going. I've got this picture in my mind. And so anything short of it is not acceptable. It's a counterfeit. Okay, so it will eliminate distractions and counterfeit. It would enhance focus. Number two, it's going to increase your persistence and your endurance, because you're going to be, you know, you're going to keep on keeping on until you achieve that goal. Number three, it increases your desire. It increases your passion for this thing. You know, it enhances that desire. And like I said, where there's a will, there's a way. You know, when it's so strong, when the desire is so strong, you will find a way to make it happen. Okay, and so that's the third power of visualization. The fourth one is that it increases motivation, you know, because now you've got the fuel and the energy to keep on going, because you've got this picture so strong in your mind that, you know, you're going to keep on going until you attain it. And finally, I said it as the fifth power of visualization is that it releases the creative power, that creative energy that will help you to attract that goal into your life. So those are the five powers. We've looked so far at what visualization is, you know, and I talked about getting a mental picture of a desired future destination, event, or goal. That's what visualization is. It's about envisioning, it's about imagining, it's about conceptualizing, you know, with our mind's eye, it's about seeing a desired end or a desired goal. And then we've looked at the five powers. And then I want to give you examples of, you know, people who have who apply this principle and who have seen it work for them. I'm going to give three biblical examples first before I give a more contemporary example. You know, in the Bible, in Genesis chapter 11, it talks about the Tower of Babel, that these group of individuals came together. You know, they were united, and their vision was to build a tower from earth up to reach heaven. And, you know, the scripture says that nothing that they had imagined to do could be restrained from them. You know, that means God himself could not stop these people because, number one, they were united in purpose, but they were also united in vision. They had imagined this thing. And that's the exact way scripture puts it in chapter 11. Go and check it out. He says nothing that they had imagined could be restrained from them. So that tells you how powerful, you know, our imagination and the mind is when we visualize something that even heaven cannot stop us. Okay. So that's one example right there. Another example that of visualization being at work in scriptures is of Abraham. You remember in Genesis, I believe it's from 15 upwards, when God made this promise to Abraham. It's also in the Torah, by the way, you know that for my Jewish audience. So, you know, God gave this promise to Abraham about him being the father of this, of nations and, you know, and all that. And this was a guy who was as barren as could be, who was at that time, he was in his late 70s or mid 70s, you know. And so God wanted to help him here. Because you see, I want to say something to you, and I want you to really catch this one. This is really huge. You cannot achieve it if you can't see it. I'll put it this way. You must see it to be able to achieve it. You cannot receive anything you cannot see with your mind's eye. You have to be able to conceptualize it, you know, for your faith to get to the point where you can receive it. You have to see it to receive it. Let me put it again. Say it again. You have to see it to receive it. And I'm not talking about seeing it with your natural eye. I'm talking about seeing it with your spiritual eye, your mind's eye. You have to be able to see that vision. You have to be able to see that goal. You have to be able to see that end that you're trying to get. Okay, you have to be able to see that prosperity. You have to be able to see that health of yours, you know. You have to be able to see that new figure of yours that you're trying to attain in order for you to receive it. And so because this is a spiritual law and a spiritual principle, God needed to help Abraham and help his faith. And you know what he did? He called him out and he said, go and look at the stars. Okay, go and look at all the stars and look at the multitude of the stars. And he said, as far as your eyes can see, okay, and as many stars as you can see, okay, that is how far I'm going to bless you. And that is how many children you're going to have. So that was the visualization. God was helping Abraham to visualize, to see this greatness, to see it with his mind eye before he could ever, ever receive it. And so that's visualization principle at work. And then finally, another biblical example is none other than Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. You know, Jesus also, the Bible talks in Hebrews chapter 12, that because of the joy that was set before him, okay, that he despised the cross, despised the shame of the cross. Okay, that's what I'm talking about, endurance. So what he's saying is that Jesus put his eyes, placed his focus, you know, on the finished line, on his goal, on the objective of the glory that was ahead, of the crown of gold that was going to be placed on his head by the Father. And so as a result, he was able to endure the shame of the cross, you know, because his eyes now have seen the glory, have seen the, I beg your pardon, seen the finish line. So those are examples right there of visualization principle working for people, biblical examples. Then let's bring it to contemporary times. This is a principle that corporate America applies every day, and it's working for them. Let me tell you how they do it. They will send you a picture. Have you ever seen those before and after pictures? Okay, that's a visualization principle. Maybe they're trying to sell a weight loss pill. And so they'll take a picture of someone who used to be, you know, a bit overweight, and then the new them. They're trying to get that picture into your mind to increase your desire. And that is why, you know, they spend so much money on the mannequins and, you know, all those models and all those things, because they want us to visualize it. They want us to imagine that being us dressed like that. And because they understand that the way this principle works is that the moment you can get that picture in your mind, then ooh, la 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 la, you will find a way of achieving it. Okay, so that's how it works. And so at your own personal level, you need to see it to receive it. Do you know what Helen Keller said? You know, the one that was blind, the 20th century author, lecturer, and political activist who turned blind when she was young, a toddler. You know what she said? She said, you know, they were asking about, you know, being blind, and she said that what could be worse than being blind is having sight but not having vision. So, you know, how to apply this principle for your goals in 2010 is for you to get a vision, okay, of where you'd like to be. So the first thing is get that picture in your mind. And how do you get this picture? Get that picture by touring, by visiting the places of where you'd like to go. I'll give you this personal example. You know that I do a lot of in-person conferences and events on-site and off-site. One of my on-site events is the Total Woman Conference. And what I do with this conference is, you know, invite people, working women from the community. And I've been at the 300 level for a long time. You know, but my vision for this conference broadened, which, by the way, is coming up on the 5th of June, Saturday, 5th June 2010. So please save that date. I'll be talking to you more about the conference in future broadcast. And then also there's always information available at my website, www.royalproclamations.com. But you know what happened with my vision with this, as I was saying, is that I went to another conference and I saw the quality and I saw the number of attendees and I looked at the strategy that they applied and I thought, my God, this is attainable. I got a picture of what I believe the Total Woman Conference could be, the potential. I got that picture, and then it totally, totally changed my mindset and my goal. So one of the first things is to get a picture. You either get that picture by visiting models and you know, people who are already living your dream. You can look in the newspaper, you know, magazines and all of that, or you can get someone to actually draw that picture for you, okay? So the first thing is to get that mental picture of your destination and your goal. The second thing is to get what I call a vision board, okay? This is just a paper I brought for you as an example, but there are a lot of boards, bulletin boards that you could adapt, foam boards that you could adapt that and use as your vision board. And so you do the first thing, get that mental picture. The next thing is now, you get your board and then you write on there, for example, vision for 2010, vision board 2010, okay? And then you can divide it, your goals, into different categories. So you have your personal goals, for example, personal goal. Then you have your professional goal there. And then you have your financial goal here. And then you have your spiritual goal there. And then whatever it is, you draw it at that end. So maybe your personal goal, for example, I know a lot of people start off is about losing weight. Okay? It's to be a slimmer you. Okay, so you get a picture. It could be a picture of you when you used to be slim, of somebody that you know that is now, you know, slim. You cut off their head, put your head on there, and get this slim figure there so that you're seeing it every day. And that's what you do the same for your professional goals and all your other goals. And then according to Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2, okay, it says, write the vision. Make it plain, okay? So the next thing you do after you've drawn this, your vision board, you know, is you make it plain. And you make it plain by making this visible, putting it somewhere that's going to be visible to you every day. I recommend every day. So you can make up to 3 or 4 copies. One should be at work. One could be at home, in your bedroom, in your bathroom, in your kitchen, or your kitchen fridge. Everywhere, so that you keep seeing and getting this picture in your head every day. So that this picture is so strong, like I said, that you know that with that strong picture in your head, you'll find a way of making it happen. The other thing that you need to do in terms of applying this principle of visualization principle is that you need to affirm it daily. So you say, you know, which is another principle that's closely related. It's a principle on its own that we probably will be looking at later in the year in broadcasts to come, is the affirmation principle. But, you know, it's visualizing it and affirming and saying, you know, I see myself at my desired end. I see me slimmer, 20 pounds lighter or whatever. I see me with my $2 million contract, signing my $2 million contract, for example, you know, and so on and so forth. So, you know, the other thing is that with this principle, I just remembered now that another person that was sharing once, he shared on the Oprah Winfrey show, was Jim Carrey, the actor. You know, he was sharing when he, you know, in his early days, when he was a broke actor, you know, he didn't have any major gigs that he was doing. And then what happened was that, you know, he applied this principle. He wrote out his check for $10 million and signed it out and said it was his payment for his first major acting, opportunity. And he put a date by it, and he had this in his purse, in his wallet. I used to look at it every day, and do you know what? The rest is history. The first check that came to him for one of his big movies was for $10 million. So this principle does work. And you know what they say? They say a fool is someone who, does the same thing in, out, every day and expect different results. And I know you're no fool. Okay, and so for 2010, I'm really encouraging you to begin to apply some of these principles into your life and just watch yourself, you know, just watch yourself getting closer and closer to your desired destination. That's it for today. I hope that you have been able to get a lot of invaluable information on this broadcast. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you, particularly for 2010, I want you to keep smiling, okay? To keep smiling. Just know that you're an overcomer, you're more than a conqueror, you're a survivor, and that you're going to make it in 2010. Keep believing, keep believing. Keep learning, okay? Keep networking. Keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'm going to see you next month, okay? Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.